In this video, we're going to show you how to create structure tags in WinCC's Tag Management Editor. Structure tags are just user-defined types that can contain different elements with different data types, such as binary, word, floats, doubles, and strings. So let's get started. In this section, we're going to talk about WinCC structure tags. Structure tags are basically user-defined types, and we can use these to map to PLC memory structures, like data blocks in Siemens PLCs, but we can create our own structure and use them under internal tags, which is what we're going to do for this demo. If you recall from the demo overview, we're doing a paint color process, so we're going to create some structure tags for each of the colors, which involve a pump, a valve, and a color strength. Back in Tag Management, we're going to locate the Structure Tag node. Notice when the Structure Tag is highlighted, then we have three different tabs here in the work area. So you have to be cognizant of which one of these is selected. To get started, I'm going to right-click on Structure Tags and choose New Structure Type. And I'll give it a name, Color. And then I'll start by just adding elements to this new data type. Right-click, New Structure Type Element. And I'll give it a name, so valve on, and then with valve on selected, I will use the details of my structure type element to assign the proper data type. Now, we're not assigning addresses or anything here because these aren't actually tags. They are user-defined types, so we're creating our own data type of tag here. So I will go ahead now and finish. Notice when I highlight color, then it defaults to our structure type elements for the color tag. So I can very easily go here and just create the rest of my elements. So it makes it pretty nice. So I can do valve fail, and it will be binary because the last one was binary. And then we have a pump on. It's also binary. We have a pump fail. And we have a color strength. And we're going to make that data type to be unsigned 16-bit value. So this is our tag definition, and we have a new structure tag data type called color, and it has these types of elements. So the next step is going to be to create instances for red, green, and blue of this new data type. So next, let's create a tag group under internal tags to put our tag instances in. So I'll right-click and choose New Group on Internal Tags called Color Tags. So this will be the group where our tag instances will be. So on the Structure Tags tab, you can see that this is a list, which is empty right now, of instances of the color structure type. So I can just highlight the first item, create a structure tag called red, and it should be assigned to our internal tags connection. And then if I do that and pull out the details screen, then I can assign it directly to our color tags group. And then if we go look at our color tags group, you can see that I have, it looks like five tags in there, but they all have this prefix red dot color strength, red dot, pump fail, valve fail, and so forth and so on. So this is actually five tags in the system, but it is seen by the system as a single tag of data type color. So now that I have that, I can just go create the rest of my structure tags. We can use our spreadsheet type features to just pull down this, and it will put all of these tags in the color tags group. And then if we go back, we see that they're there.